Benjamin Williams.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Ben Williams, and I'd like to welcome you all to the 9th Annual Grambling Legends Sports Hall of Fame Induction Enshrinement for 2017. We're excited about this induction class, and we are equally excited that you all have taken time from your busy schedules to come and support the Grambling Legends in their signature event. There's an unprecedented level of excitement, enthusiasm that's going on in Grambling. With the opening of Legends Square and the convenience of shopping that those businesses will be bringing to this area, and our alums, our faculty, our staff, our student body, our friends globally are ecstatic about our leadership and the vision for Grambling State University. Let's give it up for our president, our first lady, and their family. Let's see it for them. I would also like to take a moment to recognize the continuing excellence of some of our athletic programs here at Grambling. Congratulations to Coach Cooper on winning the Western Division and also being named Coach of the Year. Coach Murray, women's basketball, the Western Conference champion, the West, the conference, and became the first Southwestern Athletic Conference women's basketball team to ever win a first-round game in the National Intercollegiate Tournament, the NIT. Coach Bertrand Lavelle, track and field, garnered another outdoor men's championship, and doing so garnered his 36th title and Coach of the Year honors. And Coach Broderick Forbes for football, winning the West, winning the conference, and winning the HBCU National Championship. Let's give it up for them. Also, we'd like to recognize one of our legends, Mr. Doug Williams, for being named Vice President of Player Relations for the Washington Redskins. Senior Vice President of Player Personnel for the Washington Redskins. Y'all show him some love. Okay, it's now time to welcome some student athletes that have been an indelible part of our school's history. We want to congratulate these individuals on their selection and their enshrinement. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to present the Grambling Legends Sports Hall of Fame inductees for 2017. Robert Atkins. Robert came to Grambling as an accomplished three-sport high school athlete and continued to display his talents and his abilities for the Tigers. His performance in two sports made it difficult to determine his preference, but he was a competitor and my roommate. The words fast and decisive do not come close to what this young man was when he made the decision to handle an opponent at the intercollegiate level or the professional level. As an educator, an entrepreneur, and community activist, Bob was a standout. He was involved in countless activities for the youth of his community, and he made us all proud as he successfully participated in numerous upper administrative responsibilities at sister universities. Ladies and gentlemen, I present inductee Robert L. Atkins, Jr. Tommy Lee Bowens. Tommy Bowens came to Grambling as one of the leading scorers in the junior college system of Mississippi. Yammy, as he's still known, was so proficient as a player that an opposing coach allegedly called Coach Hobden and suggested that he recruit Tommy. The coach did this to avoid playing against this giant anymore. Yammy honed his skills on the court as well as the academic arena. His armed services, his athletic ability led him to perform at the armed services and in the professional arena. And he was a member of the NAIA 1961 championship team. Ladies and gentlemen, I present inductee Tommy Bowens. Abbott R. Dennis III. Abbott Dennis is a man of excellence and commitment. He created a niche for himself on the gridiron, the classroom, and in the business world. Accomplishments for him are an outcome of his personal challenges and firmness of purpose. Known for his planning, his execution, his thoroughness, he stood out for many reasons during his days of football and afterward at his institution, Grambling State University, as an innovator and successful leader. He took on various leadership positions and enhanced the business and finances of the athletic department. A community person, Al could always be found managing camping logistics for Boy Scout weekends for hundreds of boys. Ladies and gentlemen, I present Albert Dennis. Brenda Gutledge Harris. Brenda arrived at Grambling with some well-known skills, having been identified earlier as a sprinter. Once here, she continued to pursue her craft through practice and performance under the tutelage of Coach Ed Stevens. Being an outstanding performer in the Southwestern Athletic Conference was a way to showcase her abilities and elevate her to recognition at leading institutions and conferences and national performances in her chosen event. Brenda graduated from Grambling in business, but after working in corporate America, she chose to take on a life of working with the most impressionable citizens, our children. She has continued her life in the Chicago educational system, in the classroom, and through the administrative arena. She has not strayed from a track and field, and she still works for children in her community as a mentor and coach. She serves her community as a servant and leader. Ladies and gentlemen, I present inductee Brenda Gutledge Harris. Warren Mack Williams. Warren came to Grambling after years as a two-sport athlete. He chose Grambling because this was where he was meant to be. His 4 years here proved that his selection of an institution was just and profound. As a contributing hardballer, Warren helped to lead the Tiger baseball team to countless wins, championships, and accolades from his freshman year through graduation. Named to numerous award lists, Warren achieved recognition as an all-star standout, as well as an outstanding tournament player. Leaving his alma mater to step up to the next level, he continued his accomplishments and again proved that he had found his purpose while at Grambling. Currently, as a workforce development professional, he supports his community's focus on his youth as a baseball instructor and coach. Ladies and gentlemen, I present inductee Warren Mike Williams. Robert Parham. If you ever wanted to see determination, you just needed to see Robert in action. If you stood in his way, you know, he went over you. Or he went around you. And Robert was unassuming and gifted. And he made his mark on the Tigers in a very positive way by helping his team win conference and national titles. Moreover, he was a recipient of recognition as he was named the Black College Player of the Year. During his time at Grambling, he was a leader on and off the field. Ladies and gentlemen, I present inductee Robert Parham. Robert Pennywell could not be with us tonight, but we'll recognize him for his accomplishments. Robert wasn't initially pursued by Grambling, but when he got here, he made a difference like no other. A native of Shreveport, he was named and received numerous awards, individuals as well as team awards. And as a result of his skill performance, he was elevated to the next level of gridiron participation. A community-involved individual, he worked for many years for the Boy Scouts of America. Ladies and gentlemen, I present Robert Pennywell. James Odell Randall. James Sapp Randall. Already an MVP when he was recruited to Grambling. Sapp brought his athletic prowess with him, having been named All-Everything in the Mobile, Alabama athletic program. He was welcomed into the Grambling family with high expectations, and he did not disappoint. Randall was named to a number of school awards and conference standings of excellence. Upward mobility was in the stars for this athlete. His recruitment to the professional ranks was almost preordained. His skills in the sport were incorporated as a part of his new responsibility, and he really stepped up to the plate. Leaving the professional ranks allowed Sapp to begin his coaching career. He successfully coached high school baseball in addition to at his alma mater. As a coach of Claflin University, he has mentored student athletes to accept nothing but excellence. Ladies and gentlemen, I present Randall O. Sapp. Randall O. Sapp, Randall. That's my boy. Bobby Ricks, Bobby Chick Ricks, was a student athlete who reached beyond the normal realm of an aspiring basketball player. Ravel, Louisiana, was a fertile ground for the development of fast, competent round ballers. That was recognized by Fred Hobden. Playing for Coach Hobden was not easy, but it was a challenge for which Bobby was ready. Chick came and he played and he captured the hearts and the confidence of the fans. When he was on the floor and he'd take a shot, everyone thought for sure that he was going to make the basket. And most of the time, he did. And Bobby went on to be a talented educator in addition to being award-winning coach in the Chicago school system, who helped his students beyond their potential. A member of the NAIA 1961 championship team. Ladies and gentlemen, I present inductee Bobby Ricks. Ernest Sterling. If you were on the campus during the time of matriculation and playing football at Grambling, you knew about Ernest Master Sterling. Master didn't come to Grambling to play football, but to play basketball. He eventually saw the opportunity to create a different future on the gridiron. His personal demeanor, coupled with his athleticism, made him a standout on the campus and the gridiron. He had an opportunity at the next level. However, his most important personal and professional achievement was returning to Grambling to coach for over 25 years. Ladies and gentlemen, I present inductee Ernest Sterling Jr.
Good evening. Let us bow our heads for our invocation, please. All wise eternal master, please bless President Gallo, the Grambling State University administration, faculty, and staff. And Father, please bless the Doug Porter family. Father God, please bless all that's gathered together here this evening. And Lord, bless the time that we have together tonight and the fellowship that will result from our time together. Lord, we ask that the food will be nourishment for our bodies, for Christ's sakes. If you can, say amen. Amen.
While President Gallo is coming, you all feel free to indulge with your salad if you like.
Well, good evening. Ben must think I'm going to be up here a while to tell you to go ahead and get started on your salads, but please go right ahead. Welcome. It's an incredible pleasure to stand here this evening before you as your president. Wow, what a difference a year makes, right? Well, I'd like to, first of all, apologize for not making the reception yesterday evening, and I want to acknowledge my wife, Christy, who's here with me this evening. We celebrated our anniversary yesterday, and as much as I love the Legends, I love my wife more. So we celebrated our anniversary yesterday. Please welcome my wife, Christy, who's here with me this evening. You know, about a year ago, I'm not going to tell you where I saw Shaq Harris, but he said, "I hear you're going to be the next president." And sure enough, just a few weeks after that, I became president. And I told the University of Louisiana system when they appointed me that I would put God first in everything that I do at Grambling State University, and that our students would be our top priority. And I think doing those two things have certainly made a difference here on this campus over the past year. And I know I'm just here for welcoming, but I think I just need to share a couple of things. Our enrollment is up. It's been up last fall and spring, summer, and our applications for this fall are up 14% over where they were last year. And fiscally, we are in great shape. Our administration, when I came in, there were so many interim positions. All of our upper administration are all permanent positions. We hired an athletic director over the last year, Paul Bryant, who's doing a super job. Not only Paul, but he surrounded himself with a team of very talented people in compliance, in marketing, in business, and so we're really building the structure that you all expect us to build in order to be able to promote Grambling Athletics the way that I think all of you would want us to do. And let's face it, so much about that Grambling G that people recognize is associated with athletics and with the band. And so we will make sure that every day we set forth to do what you all would expect us to do, and that is to promote this university, promote our athletics in such a way that it will be the kind of representation that you all expect and that you all will be proud of when you hear Grambling mentioned. I also have to say we've beefed up our communications team with Will Sutton and Alan Blakeney, who runs the TV center, all working together to make sure that we're promoting positive information coming out of Grambling State University. For too long, we let other people tell our story. We will no longer do that. Coach Ellis has been, a steadfast prayer partner in moving us forward. And I told Coach, we're going to make you proud, Coach. We're going to make everyone proud of the work that we're doing here at Grambling. We've been doing great things, but again, we were allowing other people to tell our story. We will no longer do that. One other thing I will point out, and I tease Coach Fobbs and tell him that he and I will grow old together on this campus. He makes my job so easy. When the football team wins, the president's job is very easy. So again, we can see that there is a connection between that and our applications, our enrollment, and everything that's going on. Russell Ade, who's the University Alumni Association president, he and I signed a cooperative endeavor agreement together, the first time in over 10 years that we had a formal agreement between Grambling State University and the Grambling University National Alumni Association. So I haven't seen President, the alumni president, I'm sure he Russell's here somewhere. There he is right there. So I thank you, Russell, for your work and the partnership that we've developed, because again, you expect, and we certainly have an obligation to have that kind of relationship, that there is no separation between us. So again, I thank you all for being here year after year. I thank you for all that you've done to make it possible for us to do what we do, because if you all had not been the record breakers, had not been the trendsetters, the trailblazers to put Grambling on the map, there wouldn't be anything for us to shepherd over here. So we thank you all for all that you have done. We thank you for being here. Please keep us in your prayers. Keep our students in your prayers. Here just recently, we had an opportunity to increase fees for our students, and I said absolutely not. that we would not increase the fees on our students anymore. What does that mean? Oh, a few students in the crowd that are happy to hear that. But what does that mean? That means that I need all of you as alums, as friends, as supporters of Grambling State University to step up in ways that you have not stepped up ever before, because our students need you. They need you now more than they've ever needed you. And we'll have a campaign rolling out here shortly, so be on the lookout for that. But again, we need your investment in these students so that there will be a Grambling State University for you all to continue to come back to. Because let's face it, as much as all of you did while you were here, if we don't have students now and in the future, there's nothing for you to come back for. So again, keep us in your prayers, write us checks, and support these students in ways that you've never done it before. Thank you all so much, and God bless you all. Have a great night.
Good evening. The city of Grambling is always elated to play a role in the Grambling Legends Sports Hall of Fame induction ceremony. I always like to start off by introducing the council, the Grambling City Council. Would you please just stand? Thank you. And I'd like to introduce my wife, Patricia. Would you please stand? Thank you. We always want to be here because we want to commend, we really want to commend the Grambling Legends for this ceremony in recognizing its own. And there's no greater recognition than to be recognized by your peers. So we thank you so very much. I want to thank Dr. Higgins, the whole board, for everything that they do, not only for the Legends, but the city of Grambling. I want to take a minute to talk about the inductees. You make the city of Grambling and Grambling State University internationally known. It is because of you that we have bragging rights and that we can get out and we can promote this city and university because of your efforts and successes on and off the field, around the track, and even in your chosen professions. So we thank you for giving us the opportunity to have these bragging rights. For the past 6 years, I have talked about Legend Square Retail Center. Legend Square Retail Center. And I guess most people thought, well, that would never happen. Well, tonight we are proud to say that the Legend Square Shopping Center is almost in its final stage of completion. And we have had so many people that have made this happen. And I would be remiss if I would not just quickly tell you who those people are. Not only did they come in to help us with this $10 million venture, but they wanted to be here tonight to celebrate with you. We have Kimball Development, Mike Kimball. Would you still please stand, Mike? Mike is the developer. Thank you so much, Mike. We have a group here that flew all the way in from Virginia, Hampton Roads Ventures, LLC. With this group, please stand. They help with the financing of Legend Square. Thank you. We have the RSI group, Pamela Mobley. Where are you? Remain standing, Pam. Pam is responsible for just about closing out on our hotel for the city. So thank you so much, Pam. We want to thank all of you for being here tonight. We have another group that came in from all across the United States and even from Trinidad. We have the World Conference of Mayors, and we also have the Historic Black Towns and Settlements Alliance. Would these two groups please stand? And finally, we have Ms. Beverly Thomas. Ms. Thomas, would you please stand? Mrs. Thomas has her own regional contracting company in Washington, D.C., and we brag on her because she was one of the contractors for the African American Museum in Washington, D.C. I want to thank you again for involving the city. We support the Legends 100%. And tonight, we would like to present a key to the city to all of the inductees that will come into the Hall of Fame for the Grambling Legends. Thank you very much.
Good evening. My name is Virgil Robinson. The program has me as someone else, so I wanted to make sure that I correct that. Just quickly, I'd like to give you an overview of the mission for the Grambling Legends. The mission of the Grambling Legends is to serve as the vehicle to recognize the accomplishments of former Grambling State University athletes. Additionally, it is the Legends' mission to support the growth and development of Grambling athletes, current, and the Grambling athletic program. We strive to do these things through providing our financial support. We strive to do this through providing our support physically and the support through organizations that we belong to. It is our effort that makes this a very special evening, and we're so supportive of being able to be involved with Grambling and with the Grambling University Athletic Program. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon.
My name is Howard Davis from the Legends. I'd like to take this opportunity to acknowledge and recognize some individuals that's joining us tonight. First of all, President Gallo, and thank you so much. Mayor Jones, and thank you so much. Our elected officials from the city of Grambling, visiting corporations, especially those who are involved in putting up this complex in the city of Grambling and the Legends Square. We'd like to take this time to recognize all of the legends that's in the audience. So legends, would you please stand? As you are the reason for the celebrations. Again, you are the reasons for the celebration. Thank you so much. I'd like to take this opportunity to go further and recognize the Grambling Athletic Department, Grambling State University's Athletic Department. We know that we have success in our individual sports, and we want to congratulate those guys, all of the sports, and the supporting cast. We're talking about people that works in the main office, people that help with the training, do all these things that give us the opportunity for our kids and our team to show out and show up. Congratulations to those persons. We'd like to take this opportunity to welcome and appreciate our visiting black mayors. They were in town yesterday, and they were with the celebration this morning, the visiting black mayors. Our student volunteers who do a great job. Those are student volunteers that go around and help the guys to the places and do all those things that need to be done. Where are our student volunteers? Thank you so much. Our SGA president. Yes. Miss Grambling. The women's basketball team. We'd like to recognize those. If they are here, if those coaches are here. Mm-hmm. And in passing, I would like to welcome and recognize everybody who plays a role in getting us to where we are tonight. And that's go for all the legends and all the people that contributed to them in their lives as they matured, came from childhood through adulthood, through schools and everything to get where they are today. Thank all of those individuals. Again, thank you, and let's have a great night.
Good evening. I got the duty to present a guy. You know, when you think about Grambling sports, you really think about a guy by the name of Collie J. Nicholson. And we know what Collie J. did. But that was another guy in the Ruston area that after Collie J., that was a guy by the name of Buddy Davis. I think Buddy Davis, other than Collie J., did more for Grambling sports than anybody. You know, when you think about Louisiana Hall of Fame, it was Buddy Davis who made sure that Grambling got recognized. And we have a plaque here for Buddy. I know Buddy's not here tonight, but at the same time, I think he's here in spirit. If you know Buddy, he loves Grambling State University. And this award say the Grambling Legend Incorporated present an award of recognition and distinction to OK Buddy Davis. For decades of preeminent sports, writing coverage of Grambling Tiger Sports, which led continuing recognition of institutional sports development and success in the media. Additionally, for positive, genuine coverage, exposure, as well as promotion of individuals and teams' effort in the conference, NC2A, and professional competition. The Grambling Legend, Inc., thank you for exceptional job, well done. Presented the 8th day of July, 2017, Howard Davis, Chairman, to Buddy Davis. Thank you.
Once again, as we went through the weekend, culminating with tonight's activities, I think one of the things that I learned in listening at the program today is that one of the strategies that was in place way back when they was forming HBCUs was to surround them with a town and hoping that those people in both places would coexist and promote each other. Well, I think that is exemplified by the city of Grambling and Grambling State University. It's a good marriage, and one supports the other. And we want to take the opportunity to just thank the city of Grambling for including the legends in their celebration and in their new complex. And they are putting some of the people, yeah, some of those guys, thank you. They will be forever inducted and etched into the history of the city of Grambling because they are being inducted in that wall of fame that they're putting up down there. And in reflection on that, we want to present the city with the token of our appreciation. And so as he comes up, we'll have Coach Jones to come back. Now, we'd like to recognize a group that has received a lot of accolades from, as well as they deserve, well-deserved accolades, and that's the Grambling State University football team. We are, one of the things we're very proud of and always have been proud of was the athletic prowess of Grambling State University. That was amplified this year by the Grambling State football team. And so we want to recognize them. And Coach Forbes, come up, please. As Coach Forbes approaches, I would like to mention a few things why we feel like we need to recognize them. And a lot of it has to do with off-the-field activities and things that they've done. And they've been able to carry on the tradition of excellence in our football program. One of the things that really stands out to me, and we never see it written too much, but the fact that on our varsity program, football program, there were 37 players who had honor roll numbers in the classroom, at least a 3-point average, 37 players on that roster. And that's a tribute to the people that's handling those kids and the leadership that's provided by Coach Forbes.
Coach, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yes. Thank you.
I need to say something.
First of all, to God be the glory. I thank my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ for this opportunity and for the legends and for so many of you that support not only Grambling State University athletics, but also our university as well. It's an honor and a privilege to be here. It's an honor and a privilege to recognize so many great people that have done so many great things. I would also like to congratulate all of the honorees tonight and all the people involved that have put this event together. Thank you guys so much.
I need some glasses. The Grambling Legends was named in honor of four outstanding leaders: Eddie Robinson, Coach Fred D. Hobden, College A. Nicholson, and Prez Jones. Tonight, you know, we honor Mariette Jones, who goes about his business in the same manner. His passion and commitment has enhanced the progress and development of the city of Grambling and Grambling State University as a result of the Grambling and Legend new facility being built. I would like to read to you the Grambling Legend's recognition of Mayor Jones. The Grambling Legends Incorporated presents award recognition and appreciation to the Honorable Edward Jones, Mayor, City of Grambling, Louisiana, for your guidance, passion, understanding, leadership, and restoring history and recognition, the part that the institution's athletic program and success in recognition of the broader community for your inclusion and visionary effort in Legend Square Project, which includes as well the efforts of the Grambling Legends and other recognition to involvement. We thank you for your continuous dedication. Presented the 8th day of July, 2017, Howard Davis, Chairman. Mayor Jones,
thank you so very much. Last year, maybe the year before, Mr. and Mrs. James Shaq Harris invited the members of the World Conference of Mayors and me to their home, and I think we ate up all of her food. But, you know, we thanked him on the way out, and he said, never thank me. He said, because this is just the Grambling way. So I just want to thank you, even though I don't have to, because I know that's what we do for one another. I am certainly grateful for this plaque. Thank you so very much.